I think if I didn't walk into Bio 180 when I did, and I think if I did not have Scott Freeman as a teacher when I did, I think I would have dropped out of college. When I came to the University of Washington and walked into Kane 130 with 600 people and a balcony, it was pretty intimidating. And I thought instantly, oh, I'm gonna be lectured at. But I found out really quickly it was not gonna be like the other lecture-based classes I had been in.
In lecturing, what you're doing is you're transmitting information. And the problem is that then the students have to go home and really figure it out. Students from wealthier backgrounds, from privileged backgrounds, went to stellar high schools, they have the skills to go home and do that. The students who are less well prepared don't. An active learning classroom is where the students are engaged in working on the material, usually through peer interaction. So usually they're working with small groups, figuring out the answer to the question that's been posed, or working on a problem. But the essence of the approach is that instead of listening passively, that the students are actively trying to use the information that they're dealing with that day. In a college classroom, whoever's working the hardest is learning the most. In a lecture, that's the instructor, dancing up and down and being entertained. In an active learning classroom, it's the students. They're the ones doing the work.
All these things like put together, you know, random call, clicker questions, worksheets, it was a way to constantly show ourselves and show our peers that we're all in this together and we're all learning biology. To go from flunking a test to having one of the highest scores in class was the best feeling in the world. I was probably as happy as I felt when I got into the University of Washington.
So we looked at papers from across science and math, hundreds of them, that compared traditional lecturing to any type of active learning. And we found overall that if you're being lectured to, you're 1.5 times more likely to fail the course. And if you're in an active learning classroom, your grade on average will go up by about half a letter grade. In an active learning classroom, the data are showing that everybody does better, but there's a disproportionate benefit to students who are underprepared when they get to college, who are first in their family to go to college, underrepresented minority students, students who are in the educational opportunity program at the University of Washington. And you look at the data on income inequality, probably the primary social and political issue we have in this country right now, and ask, where does it come from? And a lot of it is from success in college. And to me, what I'd love to see is the recognition that anyone who's capable and interested belongs in a career in science. And our job as instructors is to challenge them to be the best they can be. Not to select a few, but to help everyone with the capability and the motivation.